Narendra Modi is all set to bring in measure to improve growth stimulus. Farmers and the middle class are in for a pleasant surprise. More on that after the headlines this Wednesday evening. On the Newshour tonight, we bring you Narendra Modi's 2019 Game Changer. Super exclusive news break in just about 2 minutes. Stay tuned.
I certainly would like to say that I was not the Prime Minister who was afraid of talking to the press.
Dr. Manmohan Singh recalls his years as Prime Minister to mock Narendra Modi, says he didn't shy away from speaking to the media. BJP hits right back. Days after the Pulwama encounter, sensational unverified video goes viral, shows how forces are under attack both by the terrorists and stone pelters in the valley. ISRO launches GSAT-7A communication satellite to give more power to our forces. India's enemies put on check.
You're watching the NewsHour at 9.
Ladies and gentlemen, Team Times now brings you the biggest year-ending inside scoop from the corridors of power of the national capital. Heading into an election year, Team Modi is working overtime to put together a growth stimulus, especially in the agriculture sector, with a long-term vision. Prime Minister Narendra Modi not one to really be swayed by the freebie culture and endless populism, is somebody who's going to be working on getting a long-term vision with short-term reprieve for the farmers. Eyeing a big boost for the agriculture sector, top sources from the government tell us that the government is working towards a 4 lakh crore package for farmers with small loans intended to benefit the most, while stress will be on improving the soil quality and widening the scale of subsidized insurance policies. The larger focus will continue to be on credit availability at very low interest rates, which means good news for the farmers. That, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be the farmers' package. Not only will the farmers get immediate relief, but it will bring down the financial burden considerably. The aim is also to boost interest-free credit from cooperatives, that the farmers have more hand in cash and the distressed farmers get a reprieve. Ladies and gentlemen, this is also in tune with the Prime Minister's vision of doubling farm income by 2022. In the long term, the farmer will get self-sufficient, propelling him to an efficient and scientific support system which will alleviate rural distress and make our agricultural sector truly profitable. Let me go across to my colleague Megha Prasad, who joins me live on this show. Megha, we are being told that it's a twin package. The first, of course, is the attention that's being paid to the farmers. What does the Team Modi really have in store, and when is this package likely to be unveiled to the country?
Well, Navakaji, at the outset, let me tell you two things. First, that this particular plan, which is actively under consideration right now, clearly under the purview of the Prime Minister's office and perhaps under the guidance of the Prime Minister, this could be announced as a part of vote of accounts, which will happen, of course, the first week of Feb. And the country will get to hear about this massive plan, which is currently being worked out. So this is expected in the next session, of course, of the parliament. Now, that's number one. Number two, again, at the beginning, let me clarify that this, like you said, is not a freebie. It's not a farm loan waiver, but it is, of course, a massive package that would perhaps all included, you know, come to the tune of 4 lakh crore. That's how much the assistance will be provided. And this is, of course, to provide, bring relief to the distressed farmers across the country. Now, what is happening here is this, call it an assistance package, call it an alleviation package or a stimulus package, which is what the government perhaps might end up calling it, a stimulus package. This entails, right from the beginning, easier credit availability, increase in the minimum support price, perhaps a scheme to improve the soil quality. Also, there is an element to provide immediate relief to the small farmers. The idea is to try and get a lot of cash in the hands of the farmer. And of course, what we are being told is that, all of this is being actively looked into, but the benefit is to, the long-term benefit that they are, of course, looking at is to make the farmer self-sufficient. Like you said, an announcement was made during the budget 2018, where Finance Minister Arun Jaitley very clearly had announced reforms to ensure that the farm income gets doubled by 2020. And it is a part of that on which they are working right now. But it will, of course, be unveiled before the country as a massive, massive help to the farmers.
Well, let me get in Hina Gambhir, because she has with her the entire package that could be unveiled for the middle classes as well. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the most important part of the proposal in the works in North Block and South Block is a mega boost aimed at addressing the middle class. The government hopes to ease the tax burden, especially on the salaried class. In a significant move mulled by the tax department, the government aims to raise the standard deduction element of the salary from the present 40,000 rupees to 75,000 rupees. That's what's on the table. Revenue implications of this are at the moment being calculated, because that's the direction the salaried class needs relief, the middle classes need relief. That's the direction, and what's being worked out is how much of it can be actually sent out. The target at the moment is to raise it from 40,000 to 75,000, and anyway, try to work out how the government could then balance its revenue from other sources. This could spell some real good news for the middle class. Also, the Finance Ministry is reviewing taxation on mutual fund redemption, which was introduced in the last budget. The government is also planning to put in place attractive long-term investment schemes with an eye on putting more money in the hands of the taxpayers. This clearly is a way not just to put money in the hands of people, but also to kickstart the economy. Not only does this move leave more money in the hands of the middle class, it boosts consumption and the economy, apart from acting as an immediate relief for the salaried class. By proposing an increased standard deduction, the government aims to increase tax discipline and at the same time give multiple options to make money grow and also push up the saving plans, especially for the middle class, which has no pensions to depend upon. Let me go across to my colleague Hina Gambhir. Hina, it's the class that's somewhat being feeling a little alienated at this moment, what with the petrol and diesel price hikes in the recent months, and clearly is a class that the government needs to be looking at. So what's on the anvil, and how certain are you that this is really going to happen, the standard deduction up from 40 to 75,000?
Well, as you mentioned, Navika, that the middle class has been feeling quite alienated, and that's the reason why there are populist expectations in front of the Modi government in an election year, and the last vote on account has to walk a tightrope while maintaining the fiscal prudence. There are three very, very important things that we are learning from our sources that Modi government could be considering in its vote on account. Of course, an eye, of course, is going to be on the long-term impact of these three very important measures. So overall, if we see it, then it could be a bonanza literally for the middle class coming in on the vote on account in February next year. Number one, as you were talking about the standard deduction earlier, which the Modi government made it flat at 40,000 in the budget that was presented this year, we are learning from our sources, Navika, that could actually be increased. So the flat standard deduction for all taxpayers in the country could actually be increased from 40,000 to somewhere between 60 to 75,000 rupees. So the maximum limit is that's being proposed by the government is around 75,000 rupees. Now, why? People may just ask, where will this money really come from? From April to November, the direct tax collections have gone up by 14.7%. Till November itself, the government has already met 48% of its total direct tax collection estimate. So that's where some money could really come in from, but it'll all depend upon the overall revenue implication of the government, and then this final decision will be taken. So in all, the standard deduction could go up from 40,000 to about 60 to 75,000. Apart from that, in the budget that was introduced this year, Finance Minister had reintroduced the long-term capital gains tax on mutual funds redemption. That may be reviewed. Apart from that, some very attractive savings plans, especially with a focus on pension schemes, could be introduced as well.
Well, thanks, Sina. That seems like a package. It's being called the Modi 2019 Game Changer. That's the hashtag, ladies and gentlemen. And this time, the Prime Minister is not looking at freebies. Remember, in our conversations with the Prime Minister, we've really got a sense from him that he does not believe in freebies and needless populism. What he really has an eye on is long-term vision, looking at long-term growth, looking at medium-term, bringing relief to people, but never in the form of freebies, always in the form of a plan, of a vision that will make people and the economy grow. Thanks, Megha and Hina, for joining me on this big breaking news, going across to the debate on the other side on the Modi 2019 Game Changer.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And joining me tonight on this debate is Dr. Sombit Patra, national spokesperson of the BJP, Shehzad Poonawalla, lawyer, Juhi Singh, spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, Ashutosh Mishra, senior journalist, and Sunit Chopra, senior leader of the CPIM. But first to a segment that's called The Standpoint, where Juhi Singh takes on Dr. Sombit Patra. So my first question goes across to Ms. Juhi Singh. Juhi Singh ji, you know, should there be a culture of freebies being given, or should there be an approach for making farmers independent, making farming and a profit-making business, a profit-making occupation in this country? Or should there be just what we are seeing in the three states that the Congress has won elections in? Freebies, loan maaf kar do, loan maaf kar do, loan maaf kar do. Loan maaf karke, kya aap farmers ko एक टाइम का सोल्यूशन देना चाहते हैं और लॉन्ग रन में उनको सेल्फ डिपेंडेंट नहीं बनाना चाहते? इजंट दैट व्हाट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी इज गोइंग टू रियली एड्रेस एट दिस मोमेंट? दैट्स कॉल्ड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन पॉपुलिज्म एंड अ विजन इन थिंकिंग.
Navika, first of all, there should be a culture of honesty. If the Prime Minister says something, then he should mean it. And I think people of India have now learned to distinguish between empty, dramatic statements and what will really be implemented. So this game changer, which is being called, too little, too late. And of course, we believe in the absolute farm loan waiver, because it's, I would not say it will solve all the farm problems of the farmers, but it has to be taken before we go into any long-term solutions. And really, the Prime Minister has announced, we are waiting for the economic survey. You've announced that he'll be doing something for the middle class, for the agricultural sector, but he doesn't have long-term, does he? Let him just take into account what he has said and what has been implemented. Some dramatic statements which he never intended to implement. So let's wait for the economic survey. And there were big announcements last time, also the budget. So what has really happened on this universal health care? Yeah. This is the last budget of this government. So, I mean, I would say that we're talking about direct taxes, we're talking about standard taxes. The threatening thing is what is going to, you know, where it's going to tax us again, because there are hidden costs and the input, the crop season is already on its way. So, input costs have gone in. So, what is he stimulating? Is he going to now do the soil health cards or whatever is being announced? And I'm a farmer myself. I do it it by profession and by choice. So it's important to strike that balance.
Well, Juhi Singh ji, your time is up. Frankly not and available. I want to Let ask you just him. One question, Ms. Juhi yes. Singh. Do you want to be only cynical as a political party?
Yes.
Or would you actually welcome any of these steps? But let me get in Dr. Sambit Patra. Dr. Sambit Patra, the allegation is it's too little, too late. And why think about the long term? Because aapke paas to reh gaye 5 mahine. To long term ki baat kyun kar rahe hain?
Navika, the worst thing would be to draw the farmers into a political tug of war. I firmly believe, and I would support Juhi Singh right now over here to say that even I would not criticize a farm loan waiver. But I would say that we all need to have a scientific temperament of thinking. And what Mr. Narendra Modi has proposed, that double the income of the farmers by 2020, by 2022, we have to have set the target. The irony is, in this political tug of war since the last 70 years, the farmers are the biggest losers. Mr. Rahul Gandhi recently, after the three-state election, while addressing a press conference, said that no, this is not the solution. Loan waiver is not the solution. Infrastructure is what is required. Technology providing is what is required for the farmer. The question is, for 70 years you were at the helm of affairs. Why is it that technology could not reach the farmers? Why is it that now we are talking about soil health cards? Why is it that today we are talking about micro irrigation? These should have been inculcated as techniques right from the very beginning. Astonishingly, infrastructure did not reach the farmers and the farmers were the losers. Secondly, and very importantly, as far as credit targeting is concerned, remember, it's not too little too late. Mr. Modi, in fact, in the last budget itself had increased the credit targeting of the farmers to 11 lakh crore, which was a humongous high, a phenomenal high. Remember, 5 urea plants, 5 fertilizer plants which were closed, Ramagundam, Talcher, etc., all of them were
yes.
open. And 2 in UP itself, my sister comes from UP, they were opened by Narendra Modi. 100% neem-coated urea
yes.
was a forward way of looking as far as the farmer's distress solution is
well,
concerned.
Your time
so
is up and
no
I'm opening up the debate. I'm opening
Please,
up the debate and I
vision.
Want to get in Ashutosh Mishra. Ashutosh Mishra, is this a more scientific way of looking at things? The fact is the Prime Minister says he's implemented the MS Swaminathan recommendation which already gave a 60,000 crore relief
yes.
to farmers. Much more than the loan waiver given by the UPA in 2008. For which the CAG has said 22% of the people were not even covered and 35% of the accounts that were tested, banks had failed to get the acknowledgements from the farmers. That was your UPA loan waiver of 2008. So is a loan waiver jisme aap kisanon ke aankh mein dhool jhokte hain better? Or is there a sustainable development model for the farmers, a better way to look at solving the farmers' problems?
So first of all, I think Rahul Gandhi has succeeded in waking up the Prime Minister from his slumber, and we are hearing about all these steps. Now, talking about MSP that you were talking about, I will just quote the MSP being paid for paddy. They are paying a MSP of 1750 and the farmers are claiming that they should get 2200. So that's the first problem with all that they have done and what Dr. Patra was telling us about. The farmers were promised that they will set up that the government will help them set up solar power park sort of thing in their own farms, which the government will buy. And just now we have a report that the subsidy that was to come, the Renewable Energy Department has asked the Finance Ministry that where is the money. So, I mean, these are all big promises, and if you see many of them, for example, standard deduction that you were talking about, that will come into effect once the
Congress
will start in April when Mr. Modi will be on his way out. This is an effort to stimulate votes for our losing government.
Can I please answer?
They have woken up after being thrashed in three states and they are
It's very unfortunate. Let me give you some indicators as to why it has come now.
Navika, I'll just take a few seconds.
It has come now because today for the first time we are in a position that our fiscal deficit position is not ballooning like it used to balloon in the UPA. It is for the first time that CPI, WPI, retail inflation is under check and it's been under check for a long time. It is for the first time that direct tax collection has gone up by 15.7% compared to last year and we have now collected 6.7 lakh crore in the April to November period. It is for the first time that all this money is now being pumped back to the farmers. Yes, I understand that Mr. Modi has not done something because he thought that first I must bring all the resources together rather than spend recklessly. And therefore, this is not a populist move, but a popular move. You know, in this country, people have always said that good economics makes for bad politics. But I think this game changer will be the first time in the 70 years of this country that good economics will make for good politics because it is being done with fiscal responsibility.
With an eye on the coming elections, and of course you
is
have
there something wrong with your eye? Is there something wrong?
Is there something wrong?
What
you know, if the prime minister, if the government wants to reward honest taxpayers, if the government wants to reward honest taxpayers, you have a problem with it.
We are being trying to be shortchanged with the dream of Achhe Din. And that's being
this is Achhe Din happening. You are opposing Achhe Din happening.
I am not opposing it.
You are against the standard deduction. You don't take it. You claim on national TV. You won't take
by
it
by false promises.
No, if you think this is Achhe Din, you don't like these Achhe Din. You claim
so,
that
so
I will not take the benefit.
So, Modi who gets defeated in elections is good for India. That's what the message
is. Now you are
is.
Talking politics, you are not talking
defeated,
economics.
When
now you are talking
him,
politics.
We start seeing the economics.
You are talking
we have,
politics, you are not talking economics.
We have a finance minister who kept talking about how freebies is not good, how you cannot get this, how you cannot get that. And
I have just told
everything.
You that this is not a freebie because the fiscal deficit position is not being impacted. For the first time, our economy is looking healthy. It's become number 6th in the world. It has overtaken the economy of France. We are actually looking like a steady, healthy economy within a global turmoil.
You are growing below the growth rate that was possible if the demonetization hadn't happened. You were hurt by that. Farmers were hurt by all these things. And let's accept it. Now that they have been defeated, in three states and Rahul
and
Gandhi
Gujarat
has already said that farmers
about demonetization. UP didn't vote on demonetization.
Farmers,
Gujarat didn't vote on demonetization. You know, the problem is
because
that
at that
I think
time,
personally some people have been affected
the damage
by demonetization.
That demonetization has
what?
Done. It has taken 2 years for people to understand that they were fooled.
They were fooled. People of India.
Navika, can I just come in if you allow me a few seconds?
Dr. Sambit Patra, the fact that the Prime Minister is looking at the problems of the farmers and the middle class is a problem for them. If the Prime Minister doesn't look at their problems, they say, soye hue ko jaga denge. You know, why is the opposition so wary of any measures that the government will take? Maybe the government was waiting to instill tax discipline and give the freebies at the end of their 4.5 years after seeing what their experiment was.
Navika, it's very simple. It's no rocket science. You have to understand. Everyone on the television debate and these politicians, they have been speaking since time immemorial. Mera Bharat Mahan Banna Chahiye. Each one of us want that my country should be great. So what is a great country? Great country is the one which has great infrastructure, which really caters for everyone, the farmers, the middle class, industries, etc. Now, you don't have the fiscal discipline. You don't have the resources. Where is the money? You had only 1% of your population paying tax and you want everything in the world to come under this country's infrastructure. How was that possible? Look, what we were doing for all these years in the name of populism was only rotating the same amount of money from one pocket to the other pocket. We used to drive from here, we used to give it there. We used to take out from there, we used to give it here. What Mr. Modi has beautifully done, one example which he gave only a few days ago, was all these 70 years, the total number of industrialists who were registered under the taxation system were 66 lakhs. Now after the GST, only in a category a period of 2 years, we have 55 lakhs industrialists who have been registered. Now just imagine the scale and the speed of the work as far as increasing the resources is concerned. Direct tax also have
Sir,
gone
GST,
up. So the pool from which we can spend
are below
has
target.
Increased
Let's
and this
be
is
honest.
Going to benefit
the
everyone.
Class has
so you don't
cheated.
Want So you don't want taxes to be reduced.
Mr. Senior, Mr. Senior Journalist.
You don't want
Mr. Senior Journalist. Listen to me. I was not
interested. Is that your case? Or is it only the right of the Congress Party to
fact? So we should share facts.
I'll complete.
Ashutosh. All right. Dr. Sunit Chopra coming into the debate. Dr. Sunit Chopra.
Let me just.
Do you think this country needs.
Just 10 seconds, Sunit ji.
Okay. All right. Dr. Sambit Patra.
Just 10 seconds.
You've already spoken twice.
Sir, I'm an avid reader of Times of India. Just a second. Okay, you can speak, sir. I'm an avid reader of Times of India. Only about a couple of days ago, when I opened Times of India, the headlines was 44,000 worth loan waiver in Karnataka, but only 800 farmers benefited as yet. Just imagine 44,000 of loan waiver and only 800 farmers benefited.
What is this? What is this? Those benefits have not been accrued to other farmers, and the green list is being prepared.
Oh, Mr. Senior Journalist, don't be a senior congressy.
No, senior journalist has to tell both sides of the stories. The problem here is that anyone who speaks about the common man and people, you immediately think that he's a congress person. Why do you suffer from this inferiority complex? That anyone who disagrees with you has to be with Congress.
No, we are very inferior.
Can't you hear truth? I'm telling you.
We are very inferior. You are superior.
People who read newspapers should be knowing about that.
The issue is, Astoji, you want to see both sides of the coin.
It's already been printed.
Okay, you want to see both sides of the. You want to see both sides. Astoji, I'm asking you a simple question. Since you are quite neutral and you want to see both sides of the river. Now tell me, since 2006, it was 2006 that M.S. Swaminathan report was submitted. Who was in power in 2006 till 2014? Who did not implement?
Under less is the Modi government for not having done for anything for 4.5 years.
Who implemented the MS
and now that the elections are on its head and it is being hatched
everywhere, you should not be shouting in the middle of a debate since you are quite neutral.
No,
you should not be.
I'm opening up the line. I've got my first caller. Viewers are calling in because they think this is a game changer. Let me get in Mr. Tajinder from Faridabad. Mr. Tajinder, do you think if the government has seen tax discipline and taxpayer paying taxes in the last 4 years, if they were to relook at the tax slabs now in the next vote on account, is it going to be beating the opposition at their own game? Has it become political, or is Narendra Modi rewarding people for following the tax discipline?
Navika, thank you. I am Rajinder from Faridabad. Now, as far as your question is concerned, I don't know why the opposition by these panelists, if Narendra Modi, after having set some fiscal discipline in place, is giving some tax off to the middle class. What is the opposition these people have against that? They are fine with freebies being distributed without having physical discipline in place or budgetary provisions made for it. But when he does something which is planned and provided for, these people still have problems when middle class is getting something which they truly deserve.
Well, absolutely bang on the point, Mr. Rajendra. Absolutely. I'll put your question to the opposition panelists on my show. Deepak Kalra calling in from Agra. Mr. Deepak Kalra, what do you think?
I would like to say, as a person who comes from middle class, who works hard to run his family, and to honestly pay his tax to the government, giving the soaps to farmers, okay, at times it may be essential, but all these political parties are making it like it is a freebie that they are distributing. This is not a solution. The solution is probably that they must cut the expenses, the salary, the perks, the facilities given to member of parliament, the MLAs, the ministers. They must cut, and that's the money should be given to the farmers. Instead of increasing the money on the taxpayers, which is honestly paying the tax and getting nothing in return from.
Absolutely, Mr. Deepak Kalra. While freebie culture is not something that should be promoted, but repaying honest taxpayer is something that is welcome for the middle classes.
One statistic: by implementing Aadhaar properly, 90,000 crores has been saved to the government. Duplicate beneficiaries were weeded out, and when the farm loan waiver was given by UPA, believe this is a CAG report. 34% of farmers who got benefits, no acknowledgement was taken. 13% deserving farmers were left out. That means 47% of the real farmers did not get the benefits.
Absolutely.
All the farmers who were agitating in Delhi and Mumbai, were unnecessarily angry.
Well, Ashutosh ji, janta ki awaaz, janta ki awaaz sun lijiye. Ashutosh ji, janta ki awaaz sun lijiye.
What he doesn't know.
यही तो प्रॉब्लम है ऑपोजिशन पार्टीज के सपोर्टर्स की, जनता की आवाज सुननी नहीं है, जनता की आवाज सुनेंगे नहीं. केटीएस चौहान जॉइंस मी लाइव फ्रॉम लखनऊ. मिस्टर केटीएस चौहान, व्हाट डू यू थिंक इफ आफ्टर अ डिसिप्लिन फोर इयर्स मोदी डज दिस, इज इट बैड?
मैम गुड इवनिंग. बेसिकली एवरी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी इज making it a vote bank politics, excusing the loans, waiving off the loans. Better suggestion would be that they should provide farmers all their necessities, whether it is seed or irrigation, all facilities at a minimum, prices.
Fair point. And isn't that what Mr. Modi is proposing to do?
There is a point to it, ma'am. He's doing it, but nothing is being shown on the ground. And secondly, the farmers should be allowed they should be permitted to sell their crop at their own rates. Why should you make a rate for the farmers when an industrialist or anybody can sell his product the way he wishes to sell?
All right.
At his own rates.
Point taken. Well, MSP is only supposed to be the minimum price. Anybody can sell above that minimum price. But thank you very much, Mr. KTS Chauhan, for joining us. Ashok joins me from Greater Noida. Mr. Ashok, what do you think?
Navika, well, these opposition people, I'm sorry to say, they will always oppose. They will oppose for the sake of opposition. I think freebies in Punjab, Karnataka, or even in UP, it has not worked. So, if you think that freebies will work and they will just stop drum beating for Rahul Gandhi, fine, it's good. But if Mr. Modi is doing something, allow him to do something. Always, I think, Mr. Sambit, I don't know what is his good name, the gentleman whom he calls senior journalist, he's there to just oppose, and Mr. Sumit Chopra. We see him quite regularly. He will never have a word of appreciation for the government, even if he does something good.
Point well taken, and I'll put your question to Dr. Sumit Chopra. Mr. Sumit Chopra, the viewer says that you're always criticizing Modi, even when he's doing something positive. Respond to him, Dr. Sumit Chopra.
He does not love anyone else.
What positive is he doing? 80 officials of UP.
Only your Kim Jong Un is doing positive. No one else is doing positive.
Government hooliganism and thuggery as governance. Now, if 80 of the
just
leading officials
we're
of our country
about farmers,
have
he will go somewhere
that.
Else. But why do you love Kim Jong Un, by the way? What positive has he done for you?
Of the money that should have been given, to farmers. On the crop insurance.
You ruled Bengal for 34 years.
Sir, do you have a problem about standard deduction being raised from 40 to 75,000, Mr. Ashok? Do you have a problem or is this a step in the right direction for the Modi government?
Indirect taxation is 98%. And the poor are paying for it.
Now, can I please come in, Navika?
Small things. And the farmer is paying much more than he should for diesel. The price went down 30%, but Modi only gave them 13. That's the truth.
Navika, I want to come in.
All right, Dr. Sambit Patra. Dr. Sambit Patra, there is no comment coming in on the fact that the CAG in 2013, this is not the CAG in the Modi government, but this is the CAG in the 2013, yes, which clearly said that 22% of the test checks of the waiver said it raised serious concerns over the implementation of the loan waiver itself. 35% of the accounts test checks said the banks had failed to get the acknowledgements from farmers, and nearly 2,824 farmer accounts, the audit found the records had been tampered with, overwritten and altered. Now, that was the loan waiver given by former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh and Sonia Gandhi.
Can you blame the waiver for that? Or corrupt officials?
So
and
corrupt,
the officials okay, are corrupt today.
Why were you giving the license?
Even in the okay, Swachh okay, Bharat
okay,
scheme.
Okay, Mr. Chopra, let me answer that now. Navika, let me answer
as
this.
As rishwat okay, to officials.
Okay, theek hai.
In UP.
Theek hai. Aap suniye.
अरे अरे सर सुन तो लीजिए नाविका एज फार एज द लेफ्ट शाउटिंग एंड गिविंग आउट ऑल दिस होमिलीज आर कंसर्न लेट मी वेरी रेस्पेक्टफुली से टू माय गुड फ्रेंड मिस्टर सुनीत चोपड़ा दैट देयर इज अ फेमस सेइंग वेयर देयर इज लेफ्ट देयर इज नथिंग लेफ्ट ऑफ इकोनॉमी सो फॉर गॉड सेक प्लीज डोंट सर्मोनाइज ओवर हियर आप एक लिसनर बनिए और सुनिए नाविका इट्स एन आयरनी दैट फॉर ऑल दीस इयर्स 2012
राहुल गांधी दैट्स कम अप राहुल गांधी सेज दैट ही हैड सेड दैट इन 10 डेज दे विल डू द लोन वेवर्स दे हैव डन इट इन 2 डेज इन द 3 स्टेट्स सो डॉक्टर संबित पात्रा डज दिस पुट प्रेशर ऑन द मोदी गवर्नमेंट Or answer. Are you saying that your new game changer formula of a long term vision is going to be the road that you'll stick to?
Navika, from where has Mr. Rahul Gandhi tweeted? From Shimla, I believe. Well, that's what he has been doing. And yesterday I saw on Times Now as to how he was being tutored by all those who were behind him, including Jyotiraditya Sindhia, Ahmed Patel, etc., to utter a word as to what he should be speaking about his so-called
It's called a consultative democracy.
I mean, a man
It's called a consultative democracy.
Consultative democracy?
How relevant is that?
Is not consultative democracy. Yes. That is ignorance. Ignorance about one of the most important programs which he says is a game changer, but he does not know about that. That is not consultative democracy. Now, coming to the issue of Mr. Rahul Gandhi's tweet. Leave aside 10 days, Navika. Rahul Gandhi's family was given 70 years in this country to improve the condition of this country, condition of the farmers. Did they succeed in that? No. For old times,
you
remember, Garibi Hatao was one of the biggest jumlas of
you
India's
politics. You forget the Green Revolution.
Sir, we will you give you Nobel
Prize. While I'm running out of time,
I acknowledge that.
From USA again.
Sir, over 2 lakh farmers sir, killed themselves in Maharashtra.
The biggest jumla of
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have just one question to ask my viewers tonight. Viewers, do you think the raising of the standard deduction rate from 40 to 75,000 is something that you would welcome? If you would, then tweet to us, send us your replies on involve.in/newshour. Also, if you think that Prime Minister Modi's vision to create a long-term solution rather than just loan waivers and freebies, is that a better way of tackling the farmer distress? What do you think? Send me your questions and send me your comments on Times Now on the hashtag that we've put out. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're calling it the Modi 2019 game changer. That's the big game changer. How soon Team Modi will work it out, we'll know soon. We'll continue to follow that and we'll keep our viewers updated on all the plans because we are running into election season. Is it only about elections or is it about rewarding the honest taxpayer? Thank you very much to my panelists joining me on debate number one. Going